Welcome back to my YouTube
channel. Welcome back to Friday to Mind and Energy. We are talking about abuse, psychological or emotional or verbal abuse. Actually, verbal abuse very, very strongly affect your self-perception. This is why it's so important to be able to remove yourself from people that have these tendencies, because it corrodes you, it hurts you in the long term. Today, this is gonna be a video number 3 of this series about how the narcissists abuse you. So how the narcissists abuse you, and basically how they attack. Number one, so if you check the other video, we talk about emotional abuse, then we talk about 11 tactics of verbal abuse, and then here it's some tactic, I will give you 5 tactics about how you are attacked. And this could be a little bit diverse, so if you want to watch it, stay tuned, stay here. Let's talk about how you get attacked. And it doesn't have to be a narcissist. I repeat, it could be someone that from time to time have this pattern, one or some of those patterns, because they are unhealthy. Okay. The number one attack, tactics of attack, is call you things that you are not. Or accuse you of time. For example, you're cheating, you're selfish, you're abusive. Tell you, basically this tactic consists in 2 parts: tell you what you are and tell you what to do. So for example, if the guy is telling you that you're cheating on him, it's because he is afraid to lose you. He is afraid that easily you can find somebody that is better than him, because he hasn't treated you right. Fear that he doesn't give you enough. Fear exists because he's aware of what he's doing. And that's why he knows that he abused you. He knows that he abuses, so he calls you all these things to avoid you talking about it, or to put you down. This is how they attack you. But basically they do that because they're insecure. That's insecurity, basically. Number 2. Mimic, plagiarizing, and exaggerating. Okay, a lot of people that really suffer from narcissistic disorder of the personality or some form of it, they think that they're extremely special. So I remember I text to someone something that I didn't mean, telling them how great they are. I didn't mean it. I was joking, but it was sarcastic, right? They believe it. They believe 100% that they are that special, that wonderful, and they forgot all the facts that prove the opposite, right? So when they feel special, they feel, these people that attack you in a form that they feel entitled or justified to hurt you. And very often these people share some drama. I call it storia di lacrime, which means tear story or heartbreaking story or something like that. That express how hard they suffer, how bad their childhood is. Very often this game of plagiarizing or exaggerating or thinking that they are special, it comes with sharing in a very early stage without having any trust or without knowing each other, crying. I remember someone arrived to my house, and probably after 1 or 2 weeks I knew this person. They sit down and they cried about their terrible childhood, how the mother or the father was abusive. So the reason that this is manipulation game, guys. So the reason somebody do that is because they want to get you empathic. Normally, the people that are abusive don't have empathy, but they need your empathy and your sympathy. So if you're empathic, and you like try to give them support and listen and try to give them strength, it means that you're going to excuse their harming or hurtful abuse, because you're gonna be like, oh, this guy is so miserable. He had such a terrible, terrible childhood. I kind of understand him, you know. It make it a more easy for you to let go and compromise. The plagiarizing is they're gonna do something that you do and so much pride themselves about it, something that you already did. This is very, it reminds me of someone, maybe he's gonna watch it, watch this video. So this person comment very cruel about my profession, telling me that this is not a real job, that this is nothing, and basically that I'm nothing. And now last week he just come and very proudly announced that he's doing my job and this and this and that, and I was like, didn't you say that this was not a real job? How come you're doing this right now? I said it in a joke, of course. I was not expecting for him to respond, but plagiarizing is classical, and only they plagiate, they will do that, and then they will expect you to acknowledge and tell them how great they are. And for me, I was just speechless. I didn't know what to say. But the people that attack you or are abusive, they very often need to compete with you. That's a very unhealthy pattern about men, that they will need to compete. Yes, competing is a very, very big red flag, especially if you just met a guy and he needs to compete with you. It means that he's extremely unhealthy and extremely insecure, because the real men do not compete with women, but the opposite, they help uplift, protect them, right? So if a guy is competing with you, I will tell you, the problem doesn't come alone. So probably he will have a lot of other mental problems, including that insecurities, right? The people that compete with you, they envy you, and they need to belittle you. So just you get ready. If there is one pattern of this happening, the others will happen as well. It's like a mechanism. Often these people does not have any pity about you, and they expecting you to prize them and understand them and give them some kind of a resource like positive and blah, blah, blah. Here I would just be like, I would just ignore it. Like, seriously, it doesn't matter what you do for me. It's more important how you treat me, and if you're not nice to me, I don't care how much money you do. Number three tactic of attacks is called preemptive strike. Okay, this is some kind of a term, whatever, forget about the term, let's talk about this exactly. So what exactly they do? They call you and tell you that you do things that they are themselves. This is like a often, if somebody is doing something wrong with you, something wrong to you, they will tell you that you're the wrong one, that you're narcissistic, that you're abusive. They will slander, discredit you, sabotage you. It's just guys, because in their head, you're their enemy, basically. They don't understand. They don't get at that level. This, just remember, look this person as a sick child. They are just a sick child, guys. There is no space to be angry. There's, I mean, come on. Can you be angry at a child that is in a man's body that never grow up? No, right? The reason that they do this thing to tell you that you are what they are, call you things that they are themselves, is because they aim to make you excuse, apologize yourself, and so and so. Don't explain yourself. I again, in the video before, I comment about that, just said, okay, I am not on that level, I'm not as grow, I am working on myself, you know. Number four, and this is working with a lot of women, including the empathic game number two, but the victimize. You hurt me, poor me. So I remember I was thinking that I was helping someone when I let them in my place, and they turned it into a crazy underbridge, basically. Leaving dirty things all over the place and doing a bunch of disrespectful things, trying to order me, taking my things, stealing from me, breaking my things. And I remember at one point when I didn't want to give my computer to this person, I just take the computer. I didn't want even to explain. I decided that I don't want to share my thing with him. He pulled the computer back and try to smash my hand closing the computer. And to this, when somebody do this to me, and this is why I'm a little bit scared of myself, because if somebody hurt me, I will respond back. Let's say somebody is physically abusive, I will kick him back. So he do that, and what I did by instinct, I smash him on his knee. Oh my goodness, you cannot imagine a man 6'2", 200 pounds or whatsoever. How funny, he's trying to pretend victim and telling me that I beat him, that I hurted him so badly. So when they do, so first of all, this person will start breaking, stealing from you, destroying your property, including turn people against you, trying to prove how bad you are. And they tell you what you are and what you must be and so on and so on. So they play victim. Very often this victim playing, it's necessary to involve others. Because if they play victim with you and doesn't work, they will play victim with people around you. And this become really funny, especially if you want to taste who is your real friend. So a few months ago, when this person, I decided to stop helping him, he tried to play the victim and said, I'm homeless because of you. He's trying to make me responsible for his bad choices in life, right? And he tried to turn people against me. And guess what? It worked with the people that are not real friends. So I said to myself, okay, he do that. I dislike that he do that. But I said, I would let him do. I want to see who is my real friend. Unfortunately, it can sound funny for you. This guy was not smart enough. He didn't understand my brilliant brain, because yes, I have a brilliant brain. And I know this is not like, I was just sitting, I just sit back and watch who is my real friend. Because I'm telling you, if somebody go to my best friend and try to tell her whatever shit you wanna tell her, belittle me, tell her how bad I am, she's gonna talk to me. And I know my friend, she's gonna tell me if I did something wrong, but she will come straight to me and we're gonna have a straight conversation, right? Because of course I can be wrong, I can do wrong things as well, right? So if somebody's your friend, they're not gonna sit back behind your back and discuss how terrible you are. Just remember that. And number five way of attacking you, including verbal, emotional, psychological abuse, it's know you are. Telling you what you are. This is like really bugs me. I don't think that somebody that met me 2 months ago can tell me who I am, what I am, because they don't even know me. Like, I decide to show you something of me that I want you to see, or I want you to show the crazy one or the bad or the angry one, because sometimes my goal is to aim to receive or to cut you out of my life, especially if somebody is abusive. I'm going to show them the crazy one, right? So they don't want to be around me. I'm going to show them that I'm not fun to be around and I can be as crazy as they are, right? So when they want to show you who you are, this happens often if you dare to talk about somebody's harmful actions, right? So they will deny, be fake, delusional, refuse reality, refuse facts, deny their actions, and act like you attack them. So, talking about all this kind of attacking behavior, guys, how to face that, how to deal with that? First of all, you don't need to explain who you are. You don't have to prove anything to this person. You don't have to prove how smart you are, or that you're something, that you're not something. If they tell you that you're bad, that's their opinion, you know. Don't respond to it. But if somebody is really, really threatening you, I'm telling you, just call 911. If they treat you once, and you show them with your actions, not with your words, but you show them that you're not gonna deal with that crap, they're gonna control their anger, I promise you. Don't be afraid to stand for yourself, but I don't say stand by screaming and smashing back at this person. Call the police, call the cops, remove yourself, move yourself from this situation. And if somebody is feeling okay to destroy your property, break your things, and destroy what is yours, you know what I did? Just for personal satisfaction, so I don't keep my anger, I break their computer back. I threw it from the second floor, and I felt completely happy with myself. This can sound crazy, guys, but you gotta let your anger come somehow, because I don't want to hurt nobody. I don't want to hurt someone. But if you break my house, if you destroy things for 2 months here in my place, and you act like you're gorgeous, I am gonna give you the same medicine back. But let me tell you something about this kind of actions. You can destroy one thing. You can destroy a computer. You can destroy a phone or whatsoever. But guys, remember, the reason why you have to remove yourself from the company of these people, it's because you don't want to become like them. Yes, you can explode one time and express your anger and break something physical, but you don't want to do this every day. You don't want to go to this pattern and show this person that you can intentionally be like that, to show them that you can be crazy as well. Because we all have that bad part in us that we can respond aggressively, right? But the reason that you're different and you're better is because you choose not to do that. This is why it's worthy to remove yourself from this kind of situation and from this kind of people, and not respond to the attacks, attacking back, but respond with your intelligence. Respond with your brain. Respond with your actions. But not actions against this person. Actions that make you feel good with yourself. And I don't mean be mean, be angry. Actually, the opposite, if you watch the movies, try to understand yourself, try to understand what you hold inside, why you do these kind of things, why this person do that to you, why you react in a certain ways. Understand what is holding you there. Because if there is something holding you, eventually you have some kind of trauma. And this person is just an opportunity for you to elaborate it and accept that you deserve better. That was everything from today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you discovered things about yourself or about others. And I hope you can use it. Use your brain and be smart, be positive. Thank you for being here. Have a great day. Bye-bye.